Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein and this week it's all about the brand new iOS 14 widgets that Todoist launched on Tuesday, or in my case, Wednesday. Now, what are widgets all about? Now, I think if I remember correctly, widgets have been on Android for a very long time. Well, it's taken Apple quite a few years to catch up. Finally, we have widgets, and Todoist have been hot on the trail, and they've got their widgets out very early. And I've been playing around with what you can do with these widgets this week. So before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button, you know, that like button right down there. And if you do want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my demo iPhone now, and I will show you how to get widgets working on your iOS device. Okay, so here we are with iOS 14 on the iPhone. And there we have, almost on my, well, bottom row, I have my Todoist. So here's Todoist, and this is my demo account. So I've got a lot of overdue schedules. By the way, if you do ever come to your Todoist in the morning and you think, oh no, I've got all these overdue tasks, all you do is hit the reschedule. I always just hit today and then go through it. But it's just quicker that way. So now it's updated. So how do we get the widget, the famous iOS 14 widget that Todoist have been talking about in their social media? Well, the first to do is just to tap. You can actually hold down and edit the home screen. You can do this on any button. And you'll see in the top right there, the plus button. So hit the plus button. And here are all your widgets. Now, the quickest way to do it is to tap in there and do Todoist to do. So hit Todoist. Now, Todoist has given us a number of options. We can have the today view. We can have a longer today view. We can have an even bigger today view. And we can have our, I guess, your productivity stats. And you can use add tasks. So we've got productivity view, see all your tasks in a list of your choice. So you can choose your today's focus if you're using the filters that I use. You can see your tasks in today. You can see your tasks in the list of, again, the list of your choice. So you get a few different ways of showing it. So let's just say that what I want to do is I want to see this widget because I want to see my view for the day. So that's done. If I tap on that, that's done. So if I tap on that, it's going to take me to my today view. So now I have my Todoist. Now, if I hold press, I can edit the widget. And now I can tap on there and I can show a filter. Oops, I don't want to see my upcoming. Let's just change that. I'm going to go into a filter and I want to see, let's just have a look. What have we got? We've got today's work, today's priority, today's deep work. So I'm going to choose today's priorities like that. And that's it. So tap on that again and tap on that again and that's done. So there we go. I've now got my today's priorities set up in my widgets. So when you tap on that, it will take you into Todoist and you've got your plus button. So that's just one option. Another one that you can do is I can just tap on that again, edit. Oops, I didn't want to edit the home screen. Let's just tap on that. Done. Just long press on that. Edit weeks. Edit. And we're going to go into the view. And I'm going to look at, again, we're going to look at a filter. And let's tap on that and let's just see. Today's work could be, I don't know what I've got in there. So there we go. So that's done. And that's going to change to today's work. And I'm all done. So there you go. Again, when you tap on it, go straight into Todoist really, really fast. Let's have a look. We'll go edit the widget again. And let's just see what some of these other views look like. So these are not, you're not going to be able to change the widget in this particular way. So what we're going to do is we'll cancel that and I'm going to come out. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to long press and we're going to remove this widget. Let's just click remove, and that's done. Let's now go back into widgets. So we'll just long press on Todoist. And by the way, another thing I really like about Todoist is if you do long press, you can just quickly add a task and bang, that's straight into collecting tasks. It's actually a very, very fast way of doing it. So we're going to edit the home screen. We're going to hit plus, and we're going to choose a different one. By the way, if you don't want to do it by the search, you can just go down to here and you can see Todoist. And let's go for a long one. That's see tasks in a list of your choice. And yeah, let's do, yeah, we'll do this one. Oops, do that one. Add the widget. That goes, ooh, nicely up at the top. And click done, hold down the button, edit widget, and you can choose whatever task you want to do. I actually quite like the today one. And again, when I tap into that, it's just going to take me to my today's tasks. So there you go. There's some really good ways of using these filters. Just a short video this week, but I wanted to show you what you can do with Todoist. I actually like the smaller button because then I can do another one next to it, like my calendar. So again, oops, I did that wrong. See, I'm still learning iOS. So if I just hold that down, edit home screen, let's remove that widget, and I'll show you what I would actually prefer. So we're going to add plus, and I'm going to add Todoist. So the one I really want is the today view, so I'm going to add that widget that comes up there, and then I'm going to add plus, and I'm going to do calendar, because my calendar, again, that's what I want to do there. Add the widget, and now you can just move these around, so you can just, you can actually group them together if you wish. So don't allow. Okay, where am I going? Done. Let's go back. Let's go back into. Oh, we've lost the Todoist one. So again, if we just hold down the, so you can see how we're to do this. Edit home screen, plus, Todoist. Add the widget, and we're done. There you go. And that's how I will actually have my real iPhone. This is my old iPhone that I'm showing you on it. But this is what I actually want to see, is I want to see, be able to quickly get to my today view right there, because that's what I'm usually using my phone for. And I can quickly get to my calendar by just tapping on that, and I can see my calendar with my Todoist tasks in there. Oh, so that's just a demo calendar. So there you go. That's all about Todoist widgets. And as I say, they've actually just given this a little bit of lick and polish. It's cleaned up a bit more. If you look into Today View, there's a lot more space between it. But I haven't found any other new features in there yet. But anyway, we may see more as we go. So there you go. That's iOS 14's Todoist widget. Really new, cool new way of getting quickly to see what your tasks are for the day. And I hope you get some enjoy. Now you know how to set it up. Thanks very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week.
Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done, so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.